Hello friends, I am Professor S.R. Shinde from KK Wagh College of Agriculture Business Management, Nashik. Today we are going to discuss on a very important topic, that is integrated farming system, its definition, objectives, advantages, allied enterprises and components of integrated farming system. So let's start. What is integrated farming system? So IFS is defined as biologically integrated farming system, which integrates natural resources for farming activities to reduce farm inputs and secure sustainable production of high quality food. Integrated farming system is appropriate combination of different farm enterprises. So the farmer can use byproduct of one enterprise as an input for another one, so that the input become minimized and net profit of farmer may be increased. Let's see the objectives of integrated farming system. IFS is helpful for an efficient recycling of farm and animal waste. It minimizes the nutrient loss and also maximizes nutrient use efficiency. Adaptation of efficient cropping system and crop rotation can be done through IFS. It acts as a complementary combination of farm enterprises. It will helpful to get the maximum profit with minimum expenditure by combining different enterprises. Now, which are the advantages of integrated farming system? So there are so many advantages are here, one by one. First one is productivity. Integration of crop and allied enterprises helps to increase economic yield per unit time. Productivity increases due to intensification in time and space. Next is profitability. Produce or waste material of one enterprise can be utilized for other and it helps to minimize the expenses. Next advantage is sustainability. IFS provide an opportunity to sustain production through organic supplementation and effective utilization of byproducts. Next is balanced food. So IFS linked various enterprises to provide nutritious food from same area. Next is environmental safety. Abundant use of pesticides, herbicides, organic fertilizers, which leads to soil, water and air pollution. However, in IFS, waste material byproducts are effectively recycled using for other component as manure to enrich the soil and minimizes the pollution. Next advantage is recycling of waste. Byproduct of crop husbandry can be effectively recycled for preparation of compost. Some of byproduct can be used as feed also. Next is saving energy. Energy can be saved to some extent by utilizing organic waste to generate biogas, which can be used for cooking purpose. Next advantage of IFS is adoption of new technologies. In IFS, linking of cropping with dairy, mushroom, sericulture, floriculture, etc. make flow of money throughout the year. Then money round the year. IFS provides money through year by selling the different products of farm like eggs, milk, meat and honey, etc. Next advantage is availability of fodder, fuel and timber. So through IFS, by integration, the various enterprises can meet the demand of fodder, fuel by means of biogas and production of timber also. Next is employment round the year. So livestock crop integration, mushroom cultivation, sericulture, etc. enterprises can be provide round the year employment. Then agro industries, by linking of various enterprises, the production of farmers increases, which ultimately leads to development of agro-based industries. Next advantage of IFS is increased input use efficiency. IFS provides better scope for using available resources efficiently. Last is increases standard of living. IFS leads to increase in farmers' income, which ultimately leads to increase in standard of living of farmers. Now we move towards components of farming system or allied enterprises of IFS. The first component is dairy farming. Cow and buffaloes are reared for milk and manure purpose under dairy farming. Some important breeds of cow and buffaloes are given here. So buffaloes, like Murra, Mehsana, Jafrabadi, Surti, Pandharpuri, and in case of cows, different breeds are like Jersey, Sahwal, Holstein Friesian, etc. So space required as well as location required for cow and buffalo is given here. What kind of feed is required for these animals is also given here. Then concentrates like oilseed cake of groundnut, cotton, soybean is also used as a feed for such an animals. Next component is goat farming. It is followed by small farmers and landless labor because it does not require much of financial inputs. They are reared for the milk, meat and wool purpose. Here are some breeds of goats are given as per the region. Then goat is also called as cow of poor man. One goat gives birth to 1 to 3 kids per time. Around 40 goats can be maintained on acre of land, which gives rupees 1,20,000 to 1,50,000 net profit per year. Next component of farming system is poultry farming. Here are some breeds of egg purpose and broiler chickens. So egg purpose breeds are White Leghorn, Rhode Island Red, California Grey and Australop. And for broiler chicken purpose, White Plymouth Rock, White Cornish and New Hampshire. Layer gives 180 to 230 eggs per year. Broiler chicks ready to market within 6 to 7 weeks. It attains weight of about 1.4 to 1.7 kg. Next component is duck farming. Ducks can be used for both meat and eggs purpose. They are more popular in coastal area of country. They produce about 130 to 140 eggs per year. Indian breeds of ducks are like Sillnet Mate and Nageshwari. Egg purpose breeds are Khaki Combell, which gives about 300 eggs per year, and Indian Runner also. Meat purpose breed of duck is White Penkin, Muscovy and Olesbury. Next, White Penkin gives 3 kg weight in 40 days and it is most popular breed of duck. Next component of farming system is turkey farming. It can be grown on humid tropics. Breeds of turkey like Norfolk and Cambridge, then broad-breasted bronze. Then turkey lay around 150 eggs per year and it attains about 5 to 6 kg weight in a year. Next component is piggery farming. Pigs are maintained for production of pork. Agricultural and kitchen waste or fish and slaughterhouse waste is used as a feed for pigs. Then it attains about 10 kg body weight per month. Next is rabbit farming. Rabbit can be reared for meat and wool purpose. Its meat is rich in protein, fat and disease resistance also. Meat purpose breeds of rabbits are New Zealand White, Soviet Chinchilla and Tandem Rex. Then wool purpose breeds are Dan, Angora, Polish Bolamina. So alfalfa, wheat bran and groundnut cakes are used as a feed for such a rabbit breeds. Next component is beekeeping. Apis serrana species is specially used for hilly area and Apis mellifera used for plains. Maize, millet, sunflower and palm trees are the sources of nectar and pollen. Next component is aquaculture. Under aquaculture, fish can be reared in the farm ponds. Here are some species of fish are given. Katla, which is a surface feeder and fast grower. Next is grass carp. It feeds on aquatic plants, vegetables and cut grasses. Then kalbasu. It is a bottom feeder on debris. Then brigal. It is also bottom feeder. The next is silver carp. It is surface and phytoplankton feeder. And last one is rohu. Column feeder and feed on growing plants. Next component is sericulture. It is the practice of combining mulberry cultivation, silkworm rearing and silk reeling. Karnataka is the major silk producing state. Moriculture means cultivation of mulberry plant is called as moriculture. Types of silkworms. First type is Tussar silkworm, then mulberry silkworm, Muga silkworm, and last one is Eri silkworm. Silkworms are reared on bamboo, which are covered with rice straw, and add leaves of mulberry on that. Allow the larvae to feed on the leaves. Here we can see the different species of silkworms. Next component of farming system is mushroom cultivation. Mushrooms are the edible species of fungus with various size, shape and color. It contains proteins, vitamin C and vitamin B complex, mineral like calcium, phosphorus, potassium and copper. Different varieties of mushroom are given here. First one is oyster mushroom. It grows on paddy straw. Next is white button mushroom, which grows on compost. Paddy straw mushroom, it also grows on paddy straw. So friends, in this way we have covered the topic, that is integrated farming system, its objectives, then advantages of IFS, then different components of IFS. So I hope you like this video. Thank you.